Hello there. Thanks for clicking in today to join us. I'm Alicia Olson-Keating, a senior director on the Bell Media Research Team.
Hi, and I'm Mike Muhammad, a manager on the team.
So what do you think about the new digs, Mike? Not bad, huh? Mike and I have had the pleasure of sitting with you and going through the PPM radio ratings results in a webinar format now for 5 years. It's amazing, really, how much has changed in the industry over these 5 years. Media has evolved and developed, we're all tasked more, we think more, and we're all looking for advertising guidance and insights to ensure our clients are reaching and engaging consumers with our advertising messages.
Now, there's greater accountability and expectations as we look to better understand the new media scape and how consumers are behaving. As we come to the end of 2014, the Bell Media Research Division decided to enhance the content of our video presentations. We'll take you through a summary of fall survey results, but first, we want to start with a holistic look at radio and where this medium is at today.
This will also include looking at how radio enhances TV, as Numeris released the first cross-media database to the industry this year, so radio and TV combined. Canada is actually one of the first markets in the world that has taken this step to single-source measurement for broadcast. I can't wait to see where this goes in 2015.
Great. Now, one of the things we want to share with you today is information that showcases radio's unchanged strengths. Despite the plethora of media, radio has remained a strong option with consumers. Now, life is evolving, yes. So are consumers and the way they interact with audio. Radio has kept pace with changing times and has continued to evolve too. Radio is still reaching nearly everyone on a weekly basis. Then when we look at daily reach for 5 weekdays, the stats are remarkably strong across the board. So what's changing with these radio listeners? We've seen the evolution of radio expand onto these new listening formats, including computers, TV, and mobile devices. In fact, 30% of listeners have used a non-traditional platform to tune in the past month.
So how is radio keeping up? Radio brands are engaging listeners online and monitoring consumer habits while following the trends. Radio is not just about audio anymore. In fact, 5.4 million, or 29% of Canadians aged 18 to 54, typically listen to radio while they are using the internet. Radio stations are using this to their advantage and developing complementary visual content online. Radio stations use their website as a face to engage with listeners through DJ blogs, Instagram, Twitter feeds, and contesting. They can build in themes for advertisers or use the site as a landing page to redirect traffic for advertising clients. Many stations across the country offer mobile apps and direct access to share or purchase songs. And then there are the radio station Facebook pages where listeners can engage with station content and be part of a unique community experience. And they must be doing something right, as over one quarter of Canadians who are in that lucrative 18 to 54 demo have accessed a station site in the past month. This is up substantially from 5 years ago.
Content is king when it comes to staying relevant. We've heard a lot about content in the media world these past few years. It's important to have interesting, compelling content on radio to develop consumer interaction and to pique interest.
And now, one of the ways radio stations do this is by having branded contests that run throughout the week. Successful contests engage consumers. They get talked about and blogged about, and they create synergy for the station. They make the station more known and appealing. And that's why we'll see a lot of advertisements for radio stations that focus around the contest.
Well-executed contests will ultimately drive traffic to the station and build up audience numbers. One of my favorite station contests is Beat the Bank. This was started on Chum FM in Toronto several years ago and is now airing on many Bell Media markets across the country. Beat the Bank has had huge market awareness. When listeners in Toronto hear the sound of the money vault, they know what's coming up next. And by the way, Beat the Bank has proven success. You'll see here that listener loyalty increased by double digits during the latest Beat the Bank promotion. We've used the listener loyalty stat to show the difference between an off-promo spring season, so that's spring 2013, and this last spring when Beat the Bank was aired. The increase in loyalty percentage shows the engagement level and how a radio station promotion can develop a stronger rapport with its listeners. I think station DJs and on-air personalities actually enjoy running the contest on the station. It gives them something to talk about and an opportunity to interact with consumers live on the air.
You know, I often think of radio actually as the first real social media. If you think about it, it's that live one-on-one engagement and community feel that people really relate to. It's like that me experience.
Definitely. And that brings us to our next point. Radio connects people. Even those hard to reach millennials, nearly two-thirds of millennials say that radio plays an important role in helping them to discover new music. And in general, adults still feel that radio offers a more personal experience for them, more so than other traditional media. Radio announcers do a good job at fueling that connection. Three-quarters of listeners claim that they turn on the radio when they know their favorite personality is on the air.
I like this second stat on the slide. A whopping 70% follow their favorite radio personality or station via social media channel.
And advertisers take note. Nearly half of listeners have considered or purchased products recommended by their favorite personalities.
All in all, radio is relevant not only in its methods and digital extensions, but also in the way it touches base with the consumer. Over half of Canadians 18 to 54 say that radio plays an important role in their general daily life. Radio has that portability advantage. Over 50% of all tuning comes from a vehicle. I want to take a moment to address the bar graph on this slide off to the right, which is a fresh research that was released on November 4th. It comes from Jeff Fidler, Audience Insights. Jeff has been tracking these stats since 2010. Despite the influx of satellite, Bluetooth, iPod capabilities, and then the older technology like CDs, AM/FM radio still holds a 65% share of in-car tuning. Now, that figure is quite consistent over the past 4 years.
Now, this portability is radio's greatest strength, and this is especially true for advertisers looking for path-to-purchase opportunities. Radio reaches consumers in the morning, during the daytime, and on the drive home for their supper. It's very effective at putting a message in the driver's seat when key purchase decisions are being made.
We've discovered some very cool insights recently when using the cross-media database that Numeris put out. Again, this is the new single-source data set that was released to the industry in late spring. We're actually able to look at synergies with TV and radio audiences, a tool which has led us to look at radio's relevance today from a different perspective. Radio works especially well with TV to maintain connectivity and relevance throughout a consumer's day. Adding radio spots to a television campaign actually helps to stabilize consumer market share.
Now, this is a look at the average tuning trends with adults. The light blue line shows the daily pattern for English TV, and the light gray line shows the tuning curve for English radio. The white line looks at share of market when TV and radio are combined. As you can see, total English radio and TV's share of market doesn't drop lower than 96% throughout the day. There are complementary synergies here that can help advertisers reach consumers throughout the day with a mixed broadcast strategy.
And speaking of synergies, do you know, Mike, what the number one TV show is with contemporary hit radio, so CHR? Want to take a guess?
I'm going to say Big Bang Theory.
Close. It's actually a new series that debuted this fall, The Flash, on CTV. Now, Big Bang is number 2 in Toronto and number 5 in the Vancouver market. Again, this cross-media data set allows us to cross-examine consumers' listening and viewing and determine those nice fits. Speaking of performances and fits, let's dive into the PPM radio market results that were released on Thursday, December the 11th. This is the fall data set that covers September 1st to November 30th.
Great, let's start with the Vancouver market. Total radio reaches 93% of this population. This represents 2.3 million people. Radio listeners tune in for an average of 9.3 hours per week. Now, here's the radio landscape. This chart shows tuning in one of four quadrants. We have older females in the top right, younger females in the top left, young males in the lower left, and older males in the lower right. Now, this chart shows segmentation research that shows us what a core tuning of a station is. So we have 19 measured and encoded radio stations in the Vancouver market. The average age of the audiences in Vancouver is 43 years. We see that Sonic 104.9 is still the youngest station, and CKNW is now the oldest station in the market. Now, here are the stations with the highest reach in the Vancouver market. In first place is QMFM with 696,000 weekly listeners. In second place is The Beat, and Z95.3 comes in third place with a reach of just over 500,000 listeners. Now, some important changes in this market this fall. Team 1410 was rebranded to TSN 1040 1410. Shore 104 became LG 104.3. And Classic Rock is now Rock 101. In some other news, Jack FM had a call letter change. They're now CJAX FM. And AM 650 switched its format from adult standards to oldies. So next up are the standard market rankers. For each of the markets today, we've split the day up into three key radio day parts. We have breakfast, Monday to Friday, 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. Day, 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. and drive, 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. Note that we've used the key adult 18 to 54 buying demo, and the stations are ranked by using average minute audiences, AMA. Let's start with Vancouver's breakfast day part. Moving into first place is the Nat and Drew show on QMFM with an AMA of 12,400. In second place, we have a tie with John, Holly and Nira on The Beat and all-news station News 1130. Now, here's a look at the daytime block. In first place, we have the Olivia Jones show on QMFM with 15,800 AMA. In second place is Robin LaRose on Rock 101. And in third place is Ken Jones on Jack FM. In drive, the Ray Grover show on QMFM moves up three spots to first place with 11,100 AMA. In second place is Meredith on Jack FM. And in third is Remo featuring DJ Flipout on The Beat. Alicia will now take you through the Toronto radio market.
Thanks, Mike. In Toronto, we have an overall population of 5.7 million. Radio reaches 94% of this market, and listeners in Toronto tune in for an average of 9 hours per week. Here's the radio landscape in Toronto. There are 25 PPM uncoded and measured radio stations in the market. The average age is 42 years old. The oldest station is AM 740, and the youngest is Flow 93.5 at 32 years. We notice that it is less crowded in that younger male quadrant, with Indy and Edge being the two main stations hovering in this segment. Here's a look at the top five stations in terms of reach in Toronto. 98.1 CHFI takes top spot, reaching in excess of 1.6 million listeners each week. Virgin Radio is in a close second place, and Chum FM comes in third. During breakfast, still in first place, we have Roger, Darren, and Marilyn with a 42,300 average minute audience. Then Aaron and Mike in the morning on CHFI comes in second, and 680 News takes third spot. In the daytime block, Monday to Friday, 3 p.m. to 7 p.m, Michelle Butterly on CHFI takes first place with 33,000 AMA. In second place is Ingrid Schumacher on Chum FM, and in third place is Joanne Wilder on Q107. And then we have Boom 97.3, followed closely by 99.9 Virgin Radio. And finally, in the drive, Darren Osborne on CHFI takes first place with 32,800 AMA. Ashley Greco on Chum FM takes second, and Special Ed on 99.9 Virgin Radio comes in third. Now over to Mike for the Edmonton market.
Thanks, AOK. Here's a look at the Edmonton market, where radio reaches 95% of the 1.2 million Edmontonians. Listeners spend on average of 11.1 hours tuned per week. This is a nice, robust number. So we see that there are 18 PPM measured and encoded stations in Edmonton. Listeners have an average age of 41 years. Hot 107 is now the youngest station, and 790 CFCW is still the oldest station in Edmonton. There is a lot of activity in that lower left quadrant, so this seems to be a male-skewing radio market. So let's take a look at the reach of the top five stations in Edmonton. Now Radio is the top station with 311,000 listeners each week. The Bounds takes second place, and Virgin Radio takes third. Now there is an ownership change in Edmonton, with Rolco stations Now Radio and Up 99.3 being sold to the Jim Patterson Group. This is pending CRTC approval. Here's the breakfast daypart performance. Still in first place is Crash and Mars on Now Radio. We see the dominance of this radio show. Moving up four places to second place is Terry Evans in the Morning on K97, and the Garner Andrews Show on Sonic takes third place. Now here's the daytime block. Now Radio's Adam McHale stays in first place with a 10,900 AMA. Sonic's Rick Lee is in second, and Melissa Wright is in third spot on K97. We see some changes in market rankings on this release. On the drive home, the Rachel Day Show on Now Radio stays in top spot with 12,500 AMA. In second place, we have Lane Mitchell on Sonic. And in a tie for third is Lachlan Cross on The Bear and the Robin Ray Show on Up. Now back to Alicia with our final market, Calgary.
The Calgary market has a population of 1.3 million people. 94% of this population tune into radio, and the average listener tunes in for 9.5 hours per week. Here's a look at the Calgary radio landscape. This is the youngest PPM market, with an average age of 39 years. Now, this is a very unusual market, with no stations situated in that top right older female quadrant. Virgin Radio is the youngest station in Calgary, and AM 770 is still the oldest station. KISS FM 95.9 has the highest reach in Calgary, with 307,000 weekly listeners. Virgin Radio takes second place, and AMP Radio comes in third. Here's the breakfast day part performance. The Odd Squad on Country 105 is in first place with 7,100 AMA. Mookie and Billy on KISS 95.9 moves up five places to second, and the Jeff and Sarah Show on XL 103 takes third place, down from second on the spring release. Now for the daytime block, Scott Phillips is still in first place with 7,900 AMA. Sasha Spencer is in second place on KISS. That's a growth of 31% from the spring survey. In third position is Buzz Bishop on XL 103. And then finally, for that drive home time block in Calgary, The Road Show on Country 105 takes first place with 7,800 AMA. XL 103's Afternoon Drive with Bob Steele takes second place. And in third is Maz on KISS. Virgin takes fourth position, followed by CJ in fifth place. Phew, so that's a lot of information to take in. However, if you want a more in-depth look at the market ratings, including the Montreal markets, we've provided a link in the description section of this YouTube video where you can click through to a download of a leave-behind version of the presentation. Well, that's it for today's radio landscape. But what's a December webinar without a little holiday spirit? We recently reached out to consumers to see what type of spending they plan on doing this holiday season and how they're influenced in their decision-making. Let's take a look at the results.
Absolutely. 66% of Canadians say that radio and TV ads have influenced them to find out more about a product or service. Of those influenced, 61% plan to spend $500 or more on gifts, and 28% say they will spend in excess of $1,000 on gifts this holiday season.
So, here's our question to you. Do you have your radio advertising in place? Thanks for joining us today. Until next time, from 299 Queen Street, the Bell Media Research Team wishes you a wonderful and fruitful holiday season. Bye for now.